welcome to this video. If you're new to this channel, kindly subscribe just to show support to this video. Now, if you watched the previous video about the coffee vending machine, you're aware that I promised to bring part two, where we will include the timing details and we'll also try to simulate with time. So I'll go right ahead into it. Here is the model I have created, of course, with some few additional details that were not there in the previous version that we created in part one of the video. Of what I want to emphasize right now are the timing details that are present in the person's automata. As you can see, they repeatedly try to insert a coin, try to extract coffee, after which they make a publication to indicate coffee is taken. And between each action, the person requires a suitable delay before being ready to participate in the next one. For the machine also, we have timing details. As you can see here, the machine should take timeout, if the coffee has not, if the brewed coffee has not been taken before a certain upper time limit. Also, the other part was that after receiving the coin, the machine should take some time for brewing the coffee. Then the observer also has timing aspects in that they should complain if at any time more than 8 time units elapse between two consecutive publications. So that is what I've tried to model here. If we start with the machine automata, first of all, let me show you the declarations I have. So for the declarations, we have the clock T declared globally. We also have the channels: publish, insert coin, brewing, complain, dispense, extract, and timeout. Then also we have the broadcast channel, take coffee. I did broadcast channel, which means this synchronization can be used to trigger events for two different automata. Then for the machine automata, it starts with begin, checks for coin, then it goes into verification to verify the coin. That takes maximum 3 time units. The brewing also takes 3 time units. Then it goes into a state of coffee ready. Then it will start dispensing within 2 time units. Then it will wait. At the waiting time, it can check whether the coffee has been taken and go back to begin, or it can time out if the coffee has not been taken after 3 time units. After timeout, it goes back to begin. Now, for the person automata, it begins with inserting a coin. There's no time limit here. There's just a reset. That's why we're updating with T is equal to 0. And how to do that? You just double click on the transition. Then on the part labeled update, that is where you put your timing updates. If it was a guard, like T greater than something, you put it here. So for the brewing, it waits for the 3 time units. Then it checks for the dispense within 2 time units. Then it the person moves to the checkout. Now at checkout, they can either take the coffee within 3 time units, go to coffee taken, then publish within 8 time units. If not, if they don't take the coffee, they check whether the machine is timed out, because that will synchronize with the timeout of the machine. That means the time has been more than 3 time units, and the maximum allowed time units are 3 units before they can take the coffee, after which the machine times out. So here the person will be idle, and they'll synchronize with a complaint from the observer, which will trigger them to take coffee, and then come to coffee taken, and then they will publish. The observer just has 2 states. One is observe. He checks whether the publish has been done within 8 time units. If time exceeds 8 time units, they will complain. After complaining, of course, the person will have to take coffee and publish. Yeah, so that is all I did. If you were wondering how to place these guards, just double click on the transition or on the edge. Then this is where you place the guard, where it's labeled guard. So T greater than 8. That's an example of a guard. If you're looking for how to do an invariant, that is the maximum time limit allowed on a state. Just double click on the state, there'll be a field labeled invariant. So that's where you put your invariant. So from there, I'll just go right ahead and check whether we have any syntax errors. So click on tools, then check syntax. The errors should be displayed below here, but as you can see, we don't have any. So I'll go right ahead and simulate. I had simulated, so I will destroy this and start afresh. I normally like to see the sequence diagram, the activity, how the sequence looks like when I'm simulating. So I'm just going to show you the sequence also, and then also do take note of the timing constraints. The first transition, the person is inserting a coin. Now, as you can see, the timing constraints, we have time, there's a set there. The minimum time limit is, the lower time limit is 0, the upper time limit is 2. So that process for inserting coin should take a maximum of 2 time units. Next, the machine brews. You can see the updated time constraints there. Then after that, the machine will dispense the coffee. That also should take, the time constraints are shown there. After that, the person takes the coffee. And the timing, the maximum time allowed is 3 time units. Then after that, the person is supposed to publish. So they publish to the observer. The observer is just all this while observing. So after the publish statement, of course, we go into another cycle. So the person will insert a coin. The machine will start brewing. The machine will dispense. The person will take coffee and publish. Another cycle, they will insert a coin. Then brewing will happen. Then the machine dispenses coffee. The person takes coffee, and so on and so forth. Now, as you can see, if after the coffee has been dispensed, the person does not take the coffee within the 3 time units, as you can see here, there'll be a timeout. The machine will timeout, so it will go into a state of timed out. Then after that, the person will be idle. They have not taken the coffee, so they are not publishing. So the observer at this point will complain. After the complaint, as you can see, the coffee will, I mean, the person will change state to coffee taken. Then after that, they will publish that they've taken coffee. Then another sequence will begin. Thank you so much for watching. If you have not subscribed, kindly do subscribe. If you have any questions, you can post them on the comments. Thank you very much.